BBOR, Black Box Online Radio, coming to you from West Virginia. And yes, today is another Zodiac Killer upload, but the first thing that I would like to say is, this channel relies on your support. However, we don't accept any financial contributions. There's no Patreon for a channel like this. The way you can help out this channel is simply by visiting some of our other uploads. I know some people tune in only for the Zodiac Killer stuff, but if you would like to support this channel and help us grow, what you can do is just look at the description box and visit some of the links that we have posted there. There are going to be three links on the Casey Anthony trial, the Charles Manson family, and on George Hill Hodel. Now, some of the George Hodel stuff in the playlist will tie into the Zodiac Killer, but there are also things about the Black Dahlia murder, as well as just examining some incidents in George Hill Hodel's life and the criminal activity that surrounded the time period. So once again, that's how you can help us out. Moving on, though, to today's topic. I actually was going to do a completely different subject, not the Zodiac Killer, but I got caught up reading some things about Robert Emmett. This was one of the things to do with the Zodiac case that I'd wanted to talk about it for a while, but I wasn't exactly sure how to go about it because you'll see here in the title, Zodiac Killer Robert Emmett. And Robert Emmett isn't exactly a Zodiac Killer suspect. In fact, it's just a possibility from the 408 cipher. If you go to the last line of the 408 cipher, you'll just see famously the gibberish line, the line of letters that is just mashed together. So there's a line of letters that has not been decoded. And some people believe if you arrange them around, just to read them off what they are, R-O-B-E-T-E-M-E-T-T-H-E-H-I-P-I-E. That's how it's been solved. And people think that that means Robert Emmett the Hippie. Now, a lot of people think that they have determined what that final line of the 408 cipher means. However, what if that is the possible solution to this? Well, what do we do with it? Is Robert Emmett a person or is he a clue? And when I was trying to read up on the subject, I saw very few things. In fact, maybe I didn't see a single thing that was saying that there's this guy named Robert Emmett that was the Zodiac Killer and this is his identity. Okay, case cracked. We've solved everything. What I saw was something to the contrary. It appeared to me that Robert Emmett was being treated as a clue because the Zodiac Killer operated in the San Francisco Bay Area. And in Golden Gate Park, there is a statue to the Irish patriot Robert Emmett. And I mean, is it just like a coincidence? Is it just a very similar name? It's possible. But then I began to remember the Irish poem, one of my favorites, for what died the sons of Roisin? Was it greed? For what drove Wolf Tone to a pauper's death in a cell of cold, wet stone? Was it French or German or Dutch that inscribed the epitaph of Emmett? When we've sold enough of Ireland to be but strangers in it, for what died the sons of Roisin? Was it greed? And then, like, I began to think of Emmett in that way, and it's like, hey, you know, this guy is kind of famous. And from Google, I learned that much closer to me in West Virginia, we also have a Robert Emmett Park in Washington, D.C., named for the same Robert Emmett, the Irish patriot. So instead of saying that there's this guy named Robert Emmett who was a hippie and was the Zodiac Killer, what people do is, and like this is all over the forums, it's even on ZodiacKiller.com, ZodiacKillerSite.com, they're talking about how this could be a clue that maybe you have to look at something in Golden Gate Park, you have to find something about the statue, maybe something else to do with the name Robert Emmett, or maybe very simply showing homage to someone's Irish heritage. I mean, that's something that has also been talked about before. Now, on this one website called Tapatalk, I've never really used it before, but they talk about something else. They talk about an individual named Robert Emmett Rodefer, O-R-D-I-E-F-E-R, Robert Emmett Rodefer. also, and they believe that that could be someone that is tying into Robert Emmett the Hippie. He was an actual person, reading off here. This Robert Emmett was an actual person that grew up with Arthur Lee Allen in Southern California. When they discovered this while investigating Arthur Lee Allen, they tracked him down and he was living in Germany. American authorities had a tough time investigating him because of the German government. He worked for the U.S. military in charge of setting up camps for the soldiers and families to lessen the culture shock while in other countries. It just hit me when I saw how similar the handwriting was in the photo to the Zodiacs. That was in German, and that a past Zodiac suspect, Robert Emmett Rotifer, had spent time or still in Germany. According to the book, he was in Southern California during the killings where he attended school and was not in the area when the letter stopped. Just something to think about. Maybe Rotifer was the Zodiac, wrote the letters, and was the Zodiac while in Southern California. He must have had military training, then left for Germany by work. By no means am I saying it's him, just putting ideas down for you guys to think about. If the writing in the picture was in fact the Zodiac's, why would it be in German? The only person that I've ever heard in the Zodiac investigation, the only person I have ever heard of in the Zodiac investigation that had anything to do with Germany was Rotifer. Well, that is just painfully not true. And excuse me for going off on a tangent here. Louis Myers, a Zodiac suspect, was stationed in Germany from 1971 to 1973. Dennis Land, Thomas Horn's prime suspect for the Lake Berryessa stabbing, was also stationed in Germany, and Horn alleges that he may have committed murders there without providing too much evidence in his book. So that's another connection. Earl Van Best Jr. was fluent in the German language, learned as a kid, and his best friend was from Germany. They frequently talked in the German language. Earl Van Best's wife was from Graz, Austria. They also talked in the German language. I was actually going to talk about this a little bit more, that there really seems to be a large Zodiac connection to Germany. I don't know. Are we still dealing with the post-World War II era in 1968 and 69? I mean, could we find the same connections with Italy or France or England or something like that? I don't know. Lots of people have connections to Germany. I'm sure maybe you listening to this now have some type of connection to Germany, but if we're going to be super general or super precise, but the only suspect, the only person I have ever heard of in the Zodiac investigation that had anything to do with Germany was Robert Emmett Rotifer? Absolutely not. And once again, this was from tapatalk.com, and this was posted by someone who is remaining anonymous. Okay, well, and it says, though, he is also mentioned in Zodiac Unmasked. Now, I just to drop a little bit of news to it after that little bit of a rant about the Zodiac and connections to Germany, what I would say is that I did find a copy of Zodiac Unmasked online. I was looking up some of this Robert Emmett stuff, and somebody had uploaded a PDF of Zodiac Unmasked. Normally, I like to pay for books like that, but I don't really feel too bad about downloading Robert Graysmith's book. Because, well, maybe he has had enough attention in his life and now he's just busy writing about gorillas in the Sierra Nevadas or whatever that new thing was. But yes, I just got the PDF of Zodiac Unmasked. Maybe we'll do some discussions about that once we complete our series on Gareth Penn. And anyone listening in the future, you're also welcome to check out our Zodiac discussions on Gareth Penn. But, you know, before we dismiss any of these things about Robert Emmett or Robert Emmett Rotifer, what we can say is that somebody has the name Robert Emmett, and Robert Emmett mostly appears in the Zodiac cipher, if you do rearrange those letters that way. Now, Thomas Henry Horn is, of course, trying to say that that's not actually Robert Emmett. If you substitute the misspellings in that cipher, it reveals Robert Smith II. But the exact letters, R-O-B-E-T, Robert, it's misspelled, Emmett is spelled E-M-E-T, and then the hippie. So, like I said, though, some people think that it's a clue. So what I did was, I got on Google Maps, and I wanted to look at the statue in Golden Gate Park. Google Maps is very precise. I mean, San Francisco, it's a major city. Absolutely clear view of Golden Gate Park and the statue of Robert Emmett. But, like, I was thinking, is there a street name, a place name? Is there something that we can see here? Like, I mean, if the statue of Robert Emmett was on Arthur Lee Allen Street, I'd be like, oh my gosh. Or, you know, Gajkowski Road or something like that. I would be like, it's a clue. No, all the names surrounding Golden Gate Park were names to do with music and concourse, because, of course, the nearby facilities, Music Concourse Road was the one that it's closest to. Not a whole lot of clues there, and I was rather disappointed, and I'm only talking about it because just sharing the journey that I've been doing through some of this material, I just got caught up reading some of these things, and I wanted to talk about Robert Emmett. I mean, what it sounds like they would have had a better connection with this Robert Emmett Rotifer thing is if they wanted to go down what we've said in the past about the Arthur Lee Allen's partner theory. If you're going to say that this guy was an actual person that grew up with Arthur Lee Allen in Southern California, maybe I'm forcing a pattern on this, but it's like, I would think that it would make more sense to say that he could have been Arthur Lee Allen's partner, the person writing the letters and the ciphers, while Arthur Lee Allen would have committed the murders. But I mean, that would explain the exoneration from DNA, fingerprints, the side palm print, all of those forensic things that exonerated Arthur Lee Allen. But, I mean, I can just say, though, that it is frustrating to see that line, though, just about how no other Zodiac suspect has any connection to Germany. Like, I mean, there could be a lot of things. And I was trying to find some of this stuff in when we were doing the episode on Earl Van Best, the series on Earl Van Best and Gary Stewart's book, The Most Dangerous Animal of All, because Earl Van Best was fluent in German and Japanese, as well as his native English, of course, right? Possibly Spanish as well, but they didn't talk about that too much in the book. He grew up trilingual in English, German, and Japanese. And one of the possibilities for the 340 cipher, the reason why that cipher has never been cracked, is because it could be written in a combination of English and Japanese. The first person I heard about that was indeed Thomas Henry Horan, and he says that Robert Graysmith was the person behind it. Graysmith grew up on a military base in Japan. I believe it was Lowry Air Force Base, right? But I'm getting a little hazy on that specific detail. But when I was reading about Earl Van Best, I just began to think, is there any possibility that there could be a German connection to the 340 cipher? Or I began to look. I was using it actually as a piece of evidence against Earl Van Best. If he was so passionate about languages and his understanding of German and Japanese, why would there possibly be Japanese clues in the Zodiac mystery, but not any German language clues in the Zodiac mystery? Is there any possibility, though? This is a big challenge question. And this is the heart and soul of the challenge question. Is there any possibility that the 340 cipher has not been cracked because it is written in another language? I'm not sure about that. I mean, we have 4,200 languages to go through. I mean, we could be dealing with some Filipino stuff like Thomas Henry Horan talks about and Japanese put together. Or this could be written in German and then that's why people can't figure it out. Or we could go down the Gareth Penn route and be like, the ciphers do not have any value in their meaning. It has nothing to do with the words. It's not giving you any messages. This Robert Emmett the hippie stuff, that's just a coincidence. That just appears that way. It's about how the characters are arranged. It's about how the symbols are arranged. 24 by 17, and we're just supposed to look at the numbers. And we are talking about the 408 cipher, and one of the points of evidence that Gareth Penn provided in his book Time 17 about why he thinks that you're supposed to look at the numbers and the quantities and the arrangement of the symbols as opposed to trying to translate them into English is the final line that we've been talking about that reveals Robert Emmett the hippie is written in mostly a gibberish form. You have to rearrange the letters to get Robert Emmett. And once again, it spells out Robet, R-O-B-E-T. Emmett is spelled E-M-E-T. So he's just like, that's the clue. You're meant not to look for the words. You're meant to just look at how the symbols are arranged. And Gareth Penn will tie this into mathematical signatures using Morse code and binary and so on. But some of the other possibilities is that, well, I mean, like, actually, before I say more about possibilities, I would like to say, if you're ever reading up on Robert Emmett the Hippie, Robert Emmett in anything to do with the Zodiac, you will find that his name is going to be spelled in a variety of ways. In the cipher, it would be written R-O-B-E-T, Robet, and Emmett is spelled E-M-E-T. Some people write Emmett with two T's, some people write Emmett with one T, talking very specifically about the Zodiac case. Now, and one of the possibilities about why someone could have done that is that they would be like, even if some guy named Robert Emmett or Robert Emmett Rotifer left that as a signature, then, and someone actually does solve it, then he could just be like, hey, wait a second, that doesn't say my name. That says Robert E. Meat. You know, it's like, I mean, he's like, that's not how I spell my name. That can't possibly be me. It could be confessing. It could be revealing a person's identity, but also using it as a get out of jail free card. That's what some other people have talked about. The whole thing about, maybe you've heard something about Gyke being found in the ciphers, but spelled G-Y-K-E. Maybe somebody online was talking about that once or nine times. That we could be dealing with a lot of that stuff in the Zodiac Killer mystery. But what I would say is that what we have to do with this one is keep an open mind to a lot of these things. And I'm going to investigate a little bit more because I think it's so much more valuable to think of the name Robert Emmett as a clue rather than a person. I will look more into Robert Emmett Rotifer and we'll see where that goes. But, I mean, I was almost thinking, and other people were writing this stuff on forums too, confirming some of the things that I was feeling, or having the same feeling that I was. Not confirming, but having the same feeling. Robert Emmett is one piece of the clue. The Hippie is another piece of the clue. That's why when I was on Google Maps, I was looking around just to see, like, is there anything that would have a type of hippie-related context? Maybe if there was, like, a flower power or something, or just anything that could have been hippie-related. So we look for the statue of Robert Emmett, then look for this particular place in Golden Gate Park. Then we could see that, oh, is there a name? Is there a plaque? Is there something that would kind of reveal a little bit more about the Zodiac Killer? And being very theoretical. And it was something that I was curious about. That's just what I have to say about this upload here. I don't necessarily know if all of these things are an exact science. And some people genuinely think that the Zodiac loaded his material with meaningless kind of dead ends, red herrings, false clues. Gary Stewart does write about that. And Steve Hodell even, you know, like, if you can take away one thing from Steve Hodell's book on the Zodiac Killer, is that he says that the misspellings are intentional. The line of gibberish is just a line of gibberish meant to keep you constantly guessing until the end of time. We always have to bear in mind that that could have been the way what the Zodiac intended, what the author of the letters could have intended, that this is what the person wanted to do, just to always be confusing. If they just write gibberish, then no one would ever figure it out. But what I would say with this one is that, can I just ask a second challenge question? Can you think of another Zodiac suspect who had connections to Germany? I just rattled off Louis Myers, Dennis Land, Earl Van Best, and now we have Robert Emmett Rotifer, but can you think of any others? There must be a lot, and I'm still looking for that. If we can find some German language clue or something like Ein Bach Feigengesicht or something that we can find in these ciphers or in the letters that could point us that way, I have a little bit of a hunch about it, but that's all it is. Just a hunch. All right, so that's going to conclude our discussion for today. And once again, please feel free to check out our material on the Casey Anthony trial or Charles Manson or George Hill Hodel. Links will be in the description box. If you like this upload, you can hit the like button. And if you haven't subscribed yet, you're welcome to do so. But most importantly, drop some comments below so we can continue the discussion. Until next time.